Astronomy is a very strange science from the point of view that we cannot go and get a sample of what we're studying. In this sense, music is similar. There's nothing you can touch. It's only something you can feel. It's something you can try to interpret. Within the sonar calling GJ273B, my role has been scientific advising. Leuchtenstar B, so GJ273B, was discovered in 2017. So this project would not have been possible last year. We believe that it has about 3 times the mass of our own Earth, which would make it a rocky planet, as a year in that planet lasts for 19 days of our days. This planet could have liquid water and potentially life. And therefore, this is a very suitable place to send the transmission. One of the very important values is that we are transmitting at low enough bit rate that we believe that this message can be decoded. So as soon as the message leaves the Earth, in little over a second, it has passed the orbit of the Moon, and in only a few minutes, 10 minutes or so, it's beyond Mars, and in 5 hours, it's as far as Pluto, which is one of the farthest objects in the solar system. Then it enters an area called the Oort cloud. That's a reservoir of comet nuclei. So these comets that we see every once in a while come from that area. And then we exit completely the solar system. It's a completely empty space. So actually this message will find nothing until it reaches Leuchtenstar B. We know so little about life in the universe that for now we have to really go to the very basics. At least for now, we start with the assumption that life will be based on complex carbon molecules, so our organic molecules. In that framework, water is the solvent for that molecule, so liquid water is completely indispensable for life as we know it. Therefore, when we think about habitable planets, we think of planets that could have liquid water on the surface. And liquid water means that the temperature on the surface has to be between 0 centigrade and 100 centigrade. And this defines a range of orbital distances around the star. And this range of distances is the so-called habitable zone. Now, whether this life will ever evolve to be intelligent as we know it, as we think we are, this is completely unknown. If we look at the history of our own planet, 3.8 billion years of history, intelligent life has only been so during the last few millennia, which means that it's very likely that we find planets or we find places in the universe where life exists and it's in a very basic form, like bacteria. But we can think of civilizations in our galaxy that have been here for much longer than we have been. You can imagine a planet that was formed very early on. And if those planets around those very old stars eventually were habitable and had life appearing, and maybe that life became complex and maybe it became intelligent, this intelligent life has a head start compared to us of several billion years. In 25 years, if we receive a response, then this is going to be a revolution because it will put us in a position that we've never been and in which we have to think globally as a civilization or as a community, let's say, in a way that we have never done before.